तत्परं पर्याय विद्महे ज्ञानलिङ्गेश्वराय धीमहि तन्नो गुरुः प्रचोदयात्। ओम ओम योग महर्षि डॉक्टर स्वामी गीतानंद गिरी गुरु महाराज की जय। लास्ट नाइट आई गॉट अ मैसेज फ्रॉम अ स्टूडेंट एंड द स्टूडेंट वॉज आस्किंग अबाउट हाउ टू डील विद नेगेटिविटीज, द नेगेटिविटीज दैट कम बिकॉज ऑफ व्हाट पीपल थिंक ऑफ यू, say to you or say about you and affect you because you are constantly being accused, blamed and loads of negativity coming from outside. And the student was saying, how do I deal with this? I think one major understanding we need to have is no one is perfect. And if no one is perfect, we are also not perfect. And the people around us are also not going to be perfect. So if we are not perfect and people around us are not perfect, why is it we still expect everyone to be perfect when it comes to us and ourselves to be perfect when it comes to others? I think the first realization we need to have, and I'm speaking to myself also, is that we need to realize that we are our own individual self. That is what the Swarupe Avasthanam is all about, to be established in your own self and realize that everybody in this universe, everything in this universe has its own perspective of what is happening. And the perspective that it has is based on where it is physically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually. So depending on where it is, even in the evolutionary ladder, its perspective is going to be different. You know, I remember as a small kid, a young boy, running around Kamaleswami Madam. For those of you who don't know it, Kamaleswami Madam was where Ananda Ashram was functioning. And Swamiji built up this dilapidated ancient samadhi site of the Guru Parampara. And Ananda Ashram was running there till we had our huge war with the local government who took it over. And that story continues, that saga continues. And if you want to know the full story, Ammaji's book is there. The Rishi and the Rakshas. The Rishi and the Rakshashas. And it covers the entire ups and downs of that, which is an amazing exposition on this. And it also traces how India has changed in the last 5 decades while Ammaji has been here. A personal perspective on how India has changed. But I remember as a young boy running around Kamaleswami Madam, Swamiji had this hall upstairs. And this hall upstairs is where all the kids would come together on Sunday and Swamiji would conduct the puja. And he had a spatika lingam, Spatika Lingam is a crystal lingam. This crystal lingam was gifted to him by some students in the Czechoslovakia. Now it is Czech Republic. Czechoslovakia in those days, because they couldn't send money out as a dakshina for Swamiji's teachings, so they used to give him crystal items as their gifts. And they found, while they were mining, they found this amazing crystal which was a Shiva Lingam. And so they had gifted it to Swamiji, and so this crystal lingam, it still exists at the madam upstairs, would be there, and the puja would go on with all the abhisheka, milk, ghee, honey, and all the abhisheka would go on. While the bhajans were going on and Swamiji was singing, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Yes, all this would be going on. And then the kids would all be sitting there, and then they would have their class, and then they'd go down to the garden, and all hundreds of kids in the garden, Ammaji teaching, and then senior, of those kids, the senior kids became teacher pupils or pupil teacher, and so they would be different parts of the whole Kamaleswamy Madam. At least 1,000 kids every Sunday would get the yoga, the dance, the music, the swimming. But upstairs in this hall, there would be a beautiful Dakshinamurti Shiva. For me, my Ishta Devata is Dakshinamurti, the principal of the teacher, which is what I identify with in the divine. The divine as my teacher, Purve Shamapi Guruhu Kalenana Vachedat. That is the Ishvara that I connect to personally on my journey. Beautiful Dakshinamurti Shiva. Who is that? Ananda Murtim with Chinmudra. Chinmudra Ananda Murtim. And who is sitting there? Mauna Vyakya Pragadita Param Brahma Tattvam Yuvanam Parishishtam Deham Sadvishigane Avartam Brahmanishtayam Achayendram Karagalita Chinmudvanandamutim Swatmaramam Muditavadanam Dakshinamutimidem Dakshinamutimidem. Muditavadanam, cheerful countenance. That hall, as a small boy, seemed huge. So huge. The ceiling seemed to reach up into the sky. The pillars seemed to be endless. The hall seemed to be this expansive space where all of this was happening. Now when I go there, it doesn't seem so big. It's a regular sized hall, and there are some nice arches. Swamiji built everything, so there's no inside and outside. It's all one. Even in the ashram here, I have to tell people, we don't have any inside and outside because everything is connected. Huge windows, huge arches. When I was a small kid, it seemed so huge. Now when I see it, it is not so huge. What is the difference? The hall has remained the same. My perspective has changed as I have grown physically. Things either seem smaller, bigger, the colors change, people seem different, experiences seem different as we grow. And that is why as we grow, what happens is we start to have hopefully a more matured perspective. In the series that Divya has been doing with teachers of the Parampara, what I have been, I think, most overjoyed, because I'm sitting next to her managing the technical stuff, so I've been listening firsthand to all the stuff. I think what has really struck me the greatest is the fact to see the beautiful maturity in the answers of all the teachers. And to remember so many of them when they were not so mature. I was also not so mature. I'm still quite immature in that way. And to see the beautiful changes that have occurred in each and every one of them. It's so beautiful to see that growth that is there. And as they have grown, the perspective has changed. As they have grown, the perspective has changed. As we grow, our perspective changes. But then what happens? Around us, we are surrounded by people who often have not made the choice to grow. Growth is a choice. It is an option. And that is why the choice that comes from the prefrontal cortex, which has Viveka and Vairagya. Viveka and Vairagya, they are the power of choice. And as I have said in the past, and I said in the Adhikara Yoga session yesterday, the superpower of being human is the power of choice. The superpower of being human is the power of choice. And when you start to use that power, you become the superhero of your own life. You don't need a superhero to come and save you. You become the superhero who starts to do what is required in the required manner, at the required time, for the required people. Dharma starts to flourish through you. And the adharma starts to fade away. This is our own personal journey. But what happens is often we are stuck in families, we are stuck with friends, we are stuck in a society, we are stuck in a workplace where people have not used that choice. Maybe they have not yet had the opportunity to use it. And because of that, they tend to perceive us. They tend to perceive us through their own prism. They are perceiving us through their own warped perspective. If somebody perceives you through their warped perspective, you actually cannot do anything about it. Because it is their warped perspective. Now, if it is your warped perspective, yoga says, try to change your perspective, clear the perspective so that it is not warped anymore. That is why you are removing the kleshas. Because the kleshas are distorting your perspective. And in most people, the kleshas are so predominant that the perspective is totally one that is warped beyond belief. And it is from such a perspective that in order to safeguard their perspective, Abhinivesha Klesha is the primitive. I have to safeguard my perspective. My perspective has to exist. My perspective must be the perspective. That is the primitive Abhinivesha that drives them, and they start attacking you based on their warped perspective. How they have perceived your intention. How they have perceived you. And they start attacking you from that warped perspective. It is like, we have a very beautiful dog, Bukash. Now this Bukash, I think he has some psychiatric issues. And he has some very, very big issues that he goes into panic attacks. Because once he starts barking, it's very tough to get him to control. And somebody comes in. Now, if it is somebody you don't know, if it is an unknown stranger knocking, somebody with a gun at the door and he goes, it is fine. But I come in the door. come in the door and he starts. And I'm like, seriously, Bukash, if you're going to bark at me, what do I do? Anand Raj comes downstairs. Desana goes to the kitchen area. Kitchen area is Bukash's territory. So if Desana goes, I open the door, let somebody in. I know that person. And this guy is. And I'm like, Bukash, I am here. I know them. I have let them in. It is safe. You don't have to go into this. Bukash loses his marbles. Yes, Divya. That is actually what happens. She likes this face, loses his marbles. Now, it's cute when it is Bukash. You can understand it when it's Bukash. What do you do when it is one of your family members, one of your colleagues at work, one of the people in the society where you live? I think the only thing we can feel is compassion, that they are stuck where they are stuck. And Swamiji used to say that we go through multiple incarnations as a human being. And each time we go through it, we refine the humane part of our nature. And many people, Swamiji used to say, it is the first lifetime as a human being after being a buffalo, first lifetime of being a human being after being a chicken, first lifetime of being a human being after being a snake or an insect or whatever it may be there. And what happens is that they are just, the first time they've got into the human skin. But still a lot of these samskaras and vasanas are still there. The samskaras and vasanas are so strong that they don't know what it is. And then because now they have the capacity to speak, they start to justify it by saying it's all your fault. Because the moment I have said it is your fault, I am safe. Abhinivesha Klesha. And that is why the prefrontal cortex is where we say, maybe I have contributed to this issue. And the moment you start to say, maybe I have contributed, maybe it is my fault, you are actually growing, but you have now become vulnerable to the attack of such people who are empowered by their survival instinct. It's very difficult, because as you grow spiritually, you actually become more vulnerable in such situations. And that is why they say when you are arguing with an idiot, you can never win. Because the idiot will drag you down to their level and beat you by experience. Because they have been at that level so long, they know every nook and corner of that. You have never been there. And that is why just say namaste, thank you so much. That is called upekshanam. Patanjali says, in such situations, indifference, avoidance, and just say namaste, thank you very much for your perspective. I need to be going. Because the moment you try to, it's like they say, you know, don't wrestle with a pig. Because the pig will drag you down into the mud and get dirty. But the pig enjoys being dirty and being in the mud. The pig enjoys being in the mud and being dirty. So the pig is not worried about it. It is you who have tried to be clean. That say, oh my God, look how dirty I am. And this is why the more conscientious you become, the more you grow spiritually, the more vulnerable you may become in the world. Which is why the yogis went into the forests and the high Himalayan caves. Now, in present day and age, we cannot run into the cave. Because even the caves have Wi-Fi nowadays. After the last election, our Prime Minister Modiji, and irrespective of anybody's political differences, what I would like to say is, thanks to him, yoga has been given its rightful place. And the International Day of Yoga is really something that has changed a lot of perspectives. For better or worse, that's a different issue. But after the last election, I remember a photo of him. He had gone to the high Himalayas and was sitting in a cave meditating. And because he's the prime minister, all the paparazzi had gone there to take photos and videos. And someone pointed out that cave had Wi-Fi in it. And I'm like, this is a sign of the times. Even Himalayan caves have Wi-Fi these days. And so you cannot escape the world. Now, so rather than going and trying to find a cave or go into the forest, you have to create your own cave or forest within you. That is why that cave within us. That guha which is within us. I remember singing this song to Swami Dayananda Saraswati, who had written, Bho Shambho Shiva Shambho Swayambho Bho Shambho. And after I had sung it to him, Devasena was there, a few of us, we sang it to him when he visited Pondicherry. And he and Ammaji, they had a lot of good discussions about safeguarding the temples of Tamil Nadu from government interference. And this has been a big battle. Many people don't know about it, where the government interference in Hindu temples, especially in South India, has been insulting, to say the least. You know, that time he said, we had sung this in a different way, and he said, Nija guha nihita. That guha which is within us, which has the ananda. Nija guha nihita nidanta gananda ananda adishayam akshayalingam ananda adishayam akshayalingam Shambho Shiva Shambho Swayambho. That Shambho, that Shiva, transformative consciousness lies deep within us. And this is why when we deal with such people, what we have to always try is that we do not become like them. I think one of the most important challenges as you grow spiritually is when you are caught in such a situation, do not become like them. Because the more you focus on them, the more you empower them. And this is why there was a medical condition called hysteria. The name now has changed to conversion disorder. I like that change, conversion disorder. Any country that's had the missionaries come for conversion, it is a conversion disorder. They call it conversion disorder. We used to call it hysteria. And I still remember dealing with some of these patients in the Auroville Health Center when I was working as a medical officer. The most important thing when that attack is happening and the person has gone into whatever they are doing is get everybody out of the room. Leave them on their own and everything gets solved. But what happens is more and more people come. What's happened? What's happened? What's happened? What's happened? And immediately what happens is that conversion disorder, that hysteria actually becomes stronger. Because the more you pay attention to that negativity, the more the negativity grows. You have to actually bring in Patanjali Maharishi. He was the preeminent psychotherapist of all times. There's nobody who has understood the human mind better than Maharishi Patanjali. Superman, superhero Pat. Remember that, the time traveler. Seriously, I tell you, he has understood it so well. He said, when this is happening, upekshanam, do not strengthen it by paying attention to it. Because where your mind goes, the energy goes and empowers that. So you don't empower it. He said, keep a distance, upekshanam. And that indifference, the distance, let them fall in their own well if they want to. That is their business. Don't let them pull you into that well by you getting involved. People say, oh, then is it compassionate? The highest compassion sometimes may be to just let people be and you move out of their life. That may sometimes be the most compassionate thing you can ever do. Because your being there may actually be worsening the problem. As Swamiji said, you don't have problems, you are the problem. The more we develop this Upekshanam Bhava, he says, Maitri towards those who are Sukha, Karuna towards those who are suffering, Mudita, cheerfulness towards those who are trying to be good. But what do? Somebody tries to be good, we avoid them. Somebody tries to be good, we avoid them. We try to pull them down. Cheer on the good people. Come on, you are doing wonderful work. But what do? We pull them down. And when you find these negative people, sometimes it's better they are on a different planet than you, okay? Vairagya is knowing how much distance to keep from different people. Some people you can keep in your heart. Some people you can keep in your embrace. Some people you can keep in the same room. Some people you can keep in the same town. Some people it is better they are on a different continent. And some people it is better you and they are on different planets. Even different universes, that would be great. What is one practical thing you can do? Whenever this thing happens and you get uptight, why are people talking about me like this? Why are they criticizing me? Whatever I do, they criticize. Whatever I do, they are, you know, everything seems wrong to them. One simple thing is the shake, giving a good shake. A good shake. Huh? I like to always add extra version. That's what you need to do to them sometimes, but anyway, sometimes you cannot. Catch hold of all the tensions, all this negativity, hold it tight, take in a deep breath, and throw it out. And by throwing it out, what you are saying, I don't want this negativity. I don't want those negative perspectives. Another thing you can do, you can come into the Bhujangasana. What is the Bhujangasana? It is an asana that reminds us of the time that we were the cobra, we were the serpent. And in this, we start to realize there are these old primitive tendencies, reptilian tendencies, which are just based on reflex, based on old memories, samskaras and vasanas. And when you do the Bhujangasana, you are clearing yourself of those samskaras. And what can you do? One more practice, Bhujangini Mudra. Well, you keep your head down, take in a deep breath, and then as you breathe out, you hiss and come out. That hissing is like the snake hissing. You let out all the negativities. Breathe in. And then breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. And then you just relax. The Bhujangini Mudra is one of the best practices you can do whenever you are surrounded by negative people, negative influences, negative experiences. When you do the Bhujangini Mudra, you are actively letting go of the negativities. There's that beautiful story of the snake and the yogi. And the yogi had given his bhashan. Unka bhashan diya unhone ahimsa to paramo dharma, all that type. So the snake got very convinced. It said, I'm not going to bite anybody. What happened? All the people who were scared of the snake started beating the snake up. And the snake got so badly beaten up. Then it saw the yogi. It said, Yogi ji, Swami ji, you told me ahimsa. And so I started following ahimsa. And look at my state. I've been beaten up so badly. And the yogi tells the snake, you idiot snake, I told you not to bite people. I did not tell you not to hiss. So kabhi kabhi hamara life mein you shouldn't saap jaisa to bite nahi karna hai lekin hiss karna you should hiss kadika kudadu kotta kudadu ana seela sometimes you have to give that play acting as and then you put them in their place but what happens is if you don't and you think I am going to be this very non-violent ahimsa person sometimes people take you for granted and beat you to pulp so understand that other people they are responding reacting based on where they are that is their limited perception their warped perception try to clear your perception so you start to understand what is the reality so that you can deal with it yoga is not about escapism yoga is about taking responsibility so clear your perspective see is there something about me I need to correct is there something that I need to change and if you find it please change it and thank the people for pointing it out often your worst enemies can you be your best teachers because they will put you under the magnifying glass and point out every small dot that is wrong in you whereas people who love you may not do it and that is why it is so very very important so once in a while you need to hiss a bit and keep the bhujangini mudra as your practice because that bhujangini mudra enables you to let go of the negativity and strengthen your nervous system swamiji used to say for strengthening the nervous system the bhujangini mudra is very useful they used to talk of a condition called neurasthenia which was a weakness of the nervous system and I used to say the bhujangini mudra is very useful for that because what it does is it unclogs the system and I think it is very very important message let people be what they are but let us be what we need to be that is what yoga is all about have a wonderful day wherever you are Hari Om Tat Sat.